This is a WITC Learning Commons video. Today I'm going to show you how to use the Microsoft Word Citation Helper to create APA-style citations. So here I am word processing my document, and I have the APA-style header with my title and page number. And I'm just word processing my document, and I'm inserting a quote from one of my sources, and this is from a website. So I'm typing in my quote word for word as it appeared on the website. And since I took these words from a source, I want to give that source credit. So I need to insert an internal citation. And to do that, I click up on the References menu, and I tell Microsoft Word what style of citations I'm using. I select APA 6th edition. That's the style that we use here at WITC. And then I insert a citation, and I'm adding a new source. And here up comes this box. I first tell MS Word what kind of source I'm using, and I use this drop-down box, scroll down, click on website, and now I have to fill in these areas. I'm using a website, and the material was written not by an individual. No person's name was listed as the author, but this website was written by a corporate author. And that corporate author is the Library of Congress. The name of the web page is Abraham Lincoln. The name of the website is America's Story, from America's Library. The year, I carefully examined the website for a year of creation, year of most recent update. I found a copyright date, and that was 2013. I did not find a month or a day, and that's okay. I can leave those slots blank. The URL, I want to copy in here the web address of the web page, and to make my life easier, I'll just go to that web page and click to copy, and I'll go back to that box and just paste that web address right in the URL area. I'll look over this information and make sure that I've entered everything correctly. I have no typos, no errors, because that old saying, garbage in, garbage out, applies here. So everything looks good. I'll click OK. And there is that APA style citation with the parentheses, the corporate author name, comma, and year. So there's my first internal citation. Now I can continue typing my document. We'll pretend these are words that I'm typing. The next item I'm going to insert, I'm going to paraphrase a source. And a paraphrase means that I'm taking information from my source and I'm putting that information into my own words, but I'm keeping the same meaning from that source. So here is my paraphrase. Now I want to insert another citation. If that paraphrase came from the Library of Congress source, I could just click here to insert that citation. But this actually comes from a different source, so I'm going to add a new source. That box appears. This comes from a book. So I'll select book. The author of that book, David Accord. Title, What Would Lincoln Do? year of publication, 2000. City, and actually APA wants city and the two-letter state abbreviation. So I'll type that in. Publisher is Sourcebooks. And again, I'll carefully proofread to make sure I have no typos or spelling errors. And then I'll click OK. And there is that internal citation. So I could continue on like this, typing my paper and inserting one by one my internal citations and my sources. Now, it's always good to double check your citations with an APA manual to make sure that those citations are correct. The citation helper sometimes will make mistakes, or maybe I've made a mistake entering the information, so I want to check that. And if I don't have an APA manual available, I can use the OWL Purdue website, the online writing lab of Purdue University. And here is the web address of that website, the APA citation page, or I can just Google OWL Purdue APA. Over here on the left, I can see there are links to information on how to create in-text citations and reference page citations. Well, I'm just going to check my in-text citations, double check them. I know that I made one error in that book citation. Because it was a hard copy source, the book was an actual hard copy book, I should have given the page number. Well, actually, since it was a paraphrase and not a quote, APA says inserting the page number is optional. For a quote, it's required, but for a paraphrase, it's optional. But I will go back and insert that page number for the David Accord citation. So to do, I'll click on the David Accord, and I'll edit the citation. And up pops a box with pages. And I'll type in the page number, say OK. And that inserts P period 17 to tell that the information of that paraphrase comes from page 17. So that's how you edit an internal citation. Just click on it, you get that drop-down arrow, and click on Edit Citation. If you have additional questions, feel free to contact us. Go to the WITC webpage, click on the library link, you can chat with us, or you can reach us by phone or email. Click over here on Meet the Staff and Hours. Click into your campus's LRC webpage and find our phone numbers and email addresses. Thank you for watching this WITC learning video.